Hello everybody, welcome to our video tutorials. In this video we will show how to set up an EasYview to function as classical remote panel, and some enhancements in so-called remote HMI mode. EasYview is a family of visualization touch panels, designed for system-level visualization. It is customized to provide users an off-the-shelf miniSCADA visualization solution for a fleet of gensets controlled by Woodward Power Management Controllers. Besides the miniSCADA mode, EasYview as well provides the remote HMI mode that covers fully the RP-3000 XD functionalities and even more. Today we do focus on the remote HMI functionalities of the EasYview family. As well we show the advanced opportunities, for example the cascading feature, which the EasYview provides for the remote HMI operation. The EasYview family consists of three different touchscreen sizes. 7-inch, 10-inch, and 15-inch. Dependent on the size, an EasYView can show up to 4 remote screens of EasyGen 3000 XD and or LS6 XD simultaneously. At first time boot up, EasYView starts with the miniSCADA mode by default. The application mode at startup is configurable as per your preferences. To modify the settings, tap on the gear wheel. The settings screen has following settings. Network settings. Remote HMI connection setting, disregard this for now, we will talk later about this setting. Then there is display brightness. Selection for the application mode. And the apply button to save the settings. Configure the IP setup of your EasYview according to your network. Tap on the according address bar and type in the address using the on-screen keyboard. When a valid IP address was entered, the checkmark appears. Tap the checkmark to save and return to previous screen. Then, to change the application mode, select Remote HMI. When Remote HMI is selected, the options for auto connection get visible. If device list selected, there will show a list of all available devices in the network. If single HMI selected, EasyView will show the remote HMI of the aforementioned connected device. Multi-HMI is only available in the 10-inch and 15-inch EasyView panels. The 15-inch can show up to 4 HMI displays, the 10-inch, up to 2 HMI displays, of aforementioned connected devices on the screen. For now, leave the device list active. Later this can be changed as desired. Now, if all values are correct, tap Apply to save the settings. Confirm with OK, and wait few seconds. Now EasyView saves the settings and changes to application mode remote HMI. As selected, the EasyView now shows device list and lists all available EasyGen and LS6 devices in the network. As a short review, most of you may already be knowing the multicast screen of the RP-3000 XT. Here is a picture of that screen on the right side. The EasyView has a more modern overview of the devices and offers more sophisticated functions. We will go into details later. Now we want to see the remote screen of an EasyGen device. Select one of the devices and tap single HMI. EasyView establishes the VNC connection and shows the classical RP-3000 XT view, similar to how it is in the RP-3000 XT. Now, we want to show the multi-HMI. Tap the remote HMI button at the top left corner to switch back to the device list. Select up to 4 devices you want to connect to, then tap Multi-HMI. EasyView establishes the VNC connection to all 4 and shows the remote HMI screens of the selected devices. Here it is now possible to operate, configure, and troubleshoot as usual, like using the RP-3000 XT. Now just like having even 4 RP-3000 XT screens simultaneously. Now you know how easily and fast the EasyView is configured to show the remote screen for a single HMI or show multi-HMI of up to 4 devices. Let us dive a bit deeper to the further available functionalities of the remote HMI. Tap on the remote HMI button to go back to the device list. Please note to refresh the device list, for example after a change in the number of devices in the network, click on the remote HMI button again, as the list does not refresh automatically. The navigation bar on the left provides quick change between the aforementioned single and multi-HMI view. Also, there is the Settings button to enter the setup screen. To check the version information of the EasYview, just tap on the Info button. If the number of selected devices is not plausible for the appropriate mode, device count mismatch pop-up is displayed. The message is displayed if, for example, more than 4 devices on a 15-inch or more than 2 devices on a 10-inch panel selected for multi-HMI mode. As well, it is displayed if more than 1 device got selected for single HMI mode. The device list can be sorted by clicking on the device name or IP address at the header of the appropriate column. Can be ascending or descending. You also can define filters to show only certain devices, or you can filter by certain IP address. It could even be just wildcards to filter the list. To reset the filters, tap on the burger button and select Reset Filter. The EasYview furthermore provides personalization possibilities. It is possible to change following logos, boot-up logo, logo for miniSCADA, or icon on the remote HMI screen. The software tool, Woodward Updater, is available for free. More details about this topic, you can read in our application note, B37967. One further advanced feature of the remote HMI is the cascading feature. A defined primary EasYview can create up to 5 instances of the VNC server. Each instance can create a remote HMI connection to an EasyGen or LS6. A secondary EasyView then can request a remote HMI screen from the primary EasyView. When cascading not used, the setting Use Own IP remains by default at Yes. Each EasyGen XD or LS6 XD device can only have 1 active VNC connection. Therefore, in a system of multiple EasyView devices, without configured cascading feature, an EasyView does not show the remote HMI screen, which does already show on a second EasyView. To show the same remote HMI screen on another EasyView device, the remote HMI connection first needs to be released. This is inconvenient for systems with multiple EasyView devices, especially if each EasyView shall switch between different remote HMI connections. Therefore, the EasyView does support the cascading. To use the cascading feature, the setting Use Own IP is set to No. As IP address below there, the IP of the primary EasyView panel must be set. The primary EasyView is responsible to create active remote HMI connections. All the other secondary EasyView devices will send a request for a remote HMI connection to the primary one, which creates the connection and sends the remote HMI screen to the secondary devices. If the secondary device requests a remote HMI connection, which the primary has already created, a duplicated remote HMI screen is sent to the secondary EasyView device. Therefore, multiple EasyView devices can show the same remote HMI screen. These were the most important topics when working with the remote HMI mode. There is few more worth to know information we want to talk about. For example, how to switch to the remote HMI while the EasyView shows the miniSCADA without changing any setting. There is an easy way to show the appropriate remote screen of a selected EasyGen control. Tap to one of the EasyGen buttons on the left. Now in the EasyGen home screen on the right, there is a remote screen button. Tap on that button and EasyView does show the remote screen of that EasyGen control. To go back to EasyGen home, tap the appropriate EasyGen button again. As next, there is some hardware changes we want to quickly show you, compared to the RP-3000 XT. The EasyView comes with a modern and powerful 64-bit processor. The cutout has a minor change, 0.4 mm more in width, and half a millimeter in height. Regarding the housing, it remains the same in width and height, just 6 mm more in depth. That's it for now. To get any further information and documents, just follow the QR code link on the sticker at the rear of the EasyView or type wwwdmanuals.com/easyview into your browser's address bar. Thanks for watching our tutorial. Please make sure you watch also our other video tutorials.